tonight, we're hearing about an amazing story of survival from a worker inside one of those warehouses near the tracks. 11 News reporter George Lettis has it all covered for us tonight, live at the scene in Rosedale. George.
Well, Donna, this is a scene that is still quite a mess. That's why the cleanup continues even at this hour. Tonight, we spoke to a man who was about as close as we are right now and survived that blast.
What happened Tuesday afternoon in Rosedale is still running through Tim Korber's mind.
I woke up the first night in sweats, just picturing those train cars just flipping in the air.
The 30-year-old has mental reminders and physical ones of the terror he experienced, pinned underneath a collapsed ceiling inside one of these warehouses where he works. Severe body bruises, a concussion, deep lacerations on his left arm, and an injured knee are the result of what happened right after he shot this video in the moments following the train derailment and initial fire.
That is like 20 feet in front of our work.
Crazy!
It quickly got crazier when he went back inside the warehouse.
As soon as we went back in, we were in for about 10 seconds and the explosion went off and the whole building just collapsed from the inside on us. I felt like I could not move and I felt very short of breath because it was on my back, like just pushing me into the ground, and it was very hard to breathe and see. And at one point I did think, I was like, you know, this might be it. And then one of my best friends that I've worked with for 4 years now, Derek Quinlan, he saved my life, really pulled everything off me.
As for the investigation, on Thursday, the NTSB began recreating the crash between the back end of an Alban waste truck and the front of a CSX freight train. The NTSB is also looking at the safety record of Alban Waste.
This company does have a higher than average number of vehicle out of service violations.
According to the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration, the company has an unsafe driving percentage of 90.2%. The U.S. Department of Transportation threshold is 65%.
Will you give me a hug?
Korber, meanwhile, isn't sure when he'll return to work, but he's glad he could return home to what matters most.
And back live here on the scene, according to the NTSB, CSX estimates $120,000 in track damage and $500,000 in damaged equipment. And that does not even include what it will cost to clean up all those damaged warehouses. We're live in Rosedale, George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.